Good morning. I'm Len Vermillion, Editorial Director at Hart Energy. I want to welcome you to the Virtual Executive Oil Conference. This is our first conference of 2021, and today we're coming to you live. In a moment, Texas Railroad Commission Chairman Christy Craddock will join us, and you'll have the chance to ask your questions. Just remember to use the Q&A button. But first, a little perspective. Like most people, we here at Hart Energy spent nearly the last year feeling our way through the COVID pandemic. We not only faced challenges, but also encountered surprising successes that set us on a new path forward. In fact, that's what we named one of those surprises. Who knew when we got on Zoom last spring that simply have a meeting that it would develop into a new executive interview and roundtable series? But it did. Path Forward has become something close to must-see viewing on hartenergy.com. But if there's one thing that tops it, it's what you're watching right now. While we couldn't stage those in-person networking events that we've become so known for, we began experimenting with virtual events last August with Doug Midcontinent. It was an instant success. Since then, we've welcomed thousands of people to our virtual conferences. In fact, more than 2,500 people were signed up to watch this one. So while we look forward to getting back into convention halls as soon as possible, and honestly, it can't come soon enough, this virtual format will be a new tool in our kit as we march on our own path forward. Look for more virtual and hybrid events from us, and please tell us about your experience. We want to know how you think we can make them even better. Now, on with the show. While we cannot be in Midland this year, we are fortunate to have a little bit of Midland coming to us today. Chairman Craddock is a Midland native and longtime commissioner, and she's familiar with the ups and downs of the West Texas oil business, the whole state for that matter. Plus, she's a central figure in how the industry in Texas is and will be regulated, a role made probably even more important with a new administration in Washington this year. So Chairman Craddock, welcome. We look forward to what you have to tell us today.
Thank you, Lynn, and thank you all for having me this morning. And it's a new world. So we are, you've got 2,500, I had 29,000 in the spring, but I'll get to that in a minute. I think we were the biggest Zoom meeting at that point. So good morning and thank you for having me. You know, the Railroad Commission, thought I'd remind people what we do. I think most of you know if you're sitting on this conference, but you may not be in front of us all the time. So I will tell you, I think we're the most important agency maybe in the country right now, especially if you're looking at oil and gas and oil and gas regulations. So we're the oil and gas regulator for Texas. We're the oldest oil and gas regulatory body in the country and in the world. And we not only do oil and gas, and I'll get back to that piece in the drilling part in a minute, but we do some other things that are very, very important for not just this state, but across the country. So we have in Texas, 470,000 miles of interstate, intrastate, and gathering lines in this state. We're the biggest state by a sixth. And growing, I believe, and another 500,000 miles of gas utilities. We do regulation for both of those as far as safety regulation and gas utilities. We also do the rates and rate making for gas utilities. We also have coal mines in the state. And while coal may be out of favor with the new administration, coal's important, not just to Texas, but across the country. Today in Texas, if you're sitting here and it's kind of a nice day, and actually a few of us may have had air conditioning on yesterday, but coal is about 30% on any given day of our electricity grid. So it's an important part of our electricity world in Texas and across the country. We also do geothermal. People are talking about it now. Guess what? We're one of the agencies that you come to, and we haven't permitted one in 25 years, but we definitely have a couple people looking at that. We also, as we're talking about climate change today, specifically with this new administration, carbon capture with EOR, we were the first state to have it. We've been doing it since 2003 and have rules over our agency that do that as well. But the biggest thing that we really do that people think of us is oil and gas and oil and gas permitting for wells. So I thought I'd give you